Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Estep, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, An Act of Heroism Rewarded. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Psalm chapter 34, verse 22. It says, "The Lord will rescue his servants. No one who takes refuge in him will be condemned." Children, history records many heroic acts. One remarkable story concerns a young man who was thrown from a horse into the rushing waters of the Adour River. By a strange coincidence, a businessman, Mr. Labatt, a merchant in Bayonne, France, was walking on his terrace overlooking the Adour. Just at that moment, he happened to glance across the river just as the young man was thrown from the horse. Mr. Labatt had retired to this country house early in the winter because of ailing health. He actually was in his robe as he walked for a bit of exercise on his porch overlooking the river. Mr. Labatt was a good swimmer. He did not hesitate for a moment to consider the danger of the attempt or the risk to his health. Throwing off his rope, he dived into the river in a supreme effort to help the young man who had been knocked unconscious. Having lost all sensation, he must surely have perished. Mr. Labatt caught the drowning stranger at just the right moment. "Oh God," he exclaimed as he clasped him in his arms, and then recognized with a transport of joy the person he had saved. "What do I not owe thee? I have saved my own son." At the time of his action, Mr. Labatt did not know this boy was his own son, but he knew it was somebody's son. Children, what a reward for his heroism. How often we have found that when we do a good deed without thinking of ourselves, we receive a great blessing. Christ assures us that when he returns, he will reward everyone according to his deeds. "Behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be." Revelation 22, verse 12. Notice the reward is sure, and it will be according to the work we have done. Does that mean according to the motive also? Motivation is such an important part of our work. Do we do everything to the glory of God? Oh, that we might learn to live as he suggests, whether we eat or drink or whatever we do, to do it to the glory of God. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, when Mr. Labatt was moved to help a young man who was drowning without thinking about himself. He received an extraordinary blessing. He had saved his own son. Children, a question for all of us. How often do we do good deeds without thinking about ourselves, without thinking about the benefits for ourselves, without choosing who we should help? This morning, let's meditate on God's words, realizing every motive for what we do to other people, for the glory of God or for our own interest. Children, ask God to help you that in every heroic action or every good deed that you give to others, it is solely for the glory of God and to be a blessing to others. Everything you do is only because of the love of Jesus that is in you. May today, with God's guidance, you will do good things for others, without thinking about the benefits for yourselves, but believe that God has provided beautiful blessings for you in every good deed you do for others. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.